Vijay, first tell us that, you know, what is your condition about the toes?
Personally? Uh-huh. Personally, you know, we've got a lot better.
Lot better. And yeah. Then will you be able to play?
Yeah, hopefully, yeah.
Hopefully. And, you know, were you surprised that, you know, that in swing had landed on your toes?
Actually, when you play, you know, someone like Bumrah, yeah, you always expect that. But still, sometimes we do miss that.
Hi, Vijay, the team has possibly got off to as good a start as it could have expected. From the team's point of view, how do you keep going? Like, are there areas that you think needs improvement? How do you guard against complacency?
Yeah, definitely. Being a professional, it's very important to keep improving and get better every day. So that is the only thing which each and every individual think about. So if you can, you know, keep getting better, and we can set ourselves better standards every game. So, no, it's overall, like, for me, you know, I will look to you know, get better in all three aspects of the game. So, and, you know, sometimes it's very important to understand and read the situations, which will be very important at a few important time in this tournament.
Hi Vijay, it's Bashir from RTA. Afghanistan have not had the best tournament so far, but their previous performance in the Asia Cup against India, Pakistan and Sri Lanka was pretty good. How is the conversation in the changing room? Will there be any major changes for tomorrow's game, or are you taking it as the other games?
No, it's not about against whom we are playing. I think it's about how we play as individuals. So as I said earlier, we'd always look to get better, even when we get to practice session. That is the only motive that we'll have. We'll just look to get better. So it doesn't matter against whom we are playing. It is just about how we play against each and every individual. It should be the same.
Vijay, does it really feel like you're playing the World Cup the way things are going on?
Sorry?
Does it really feel for you that you're playing the World Cup, or is it just like some, just you coming up, turning up, playing a match, going back?
No, definitely. First of all, you know, it feels great to represent the country, and World Cup is really special because it happens once in 4 years. So for every individual, every cricketer, it's very special. So the first important thing is representing the country. So that feel will always be there, be it World Cup or any other tournament.
Vijay, this time last week you hadn't played in the World Cup. Now you've got a game out of the belt. You got runs. You got a couple of wickets. So has that sort of settled you down mentally getting into the tournament?
Yeah, definitely. It gives any player some confidence, because that is really needed for any individual. So last game gave me some confidence, and especially playing against Pakistan, making my debut against them, it was a very special thing for me. So performing under pressure and coming out good, and the team winning at the end of the day is very important, and felt really good at the end of the day.
Vijay, how do you think your bowling has evolved, and are there any specific things that you're looking to do, like bowling fast or swinging it and stuff like that? Because that is the differentiating part, why in you, that the fact that you're a bowling, fast bowling all-rounder.
Yeah, I've always told this, like, you know, I'll always look to get better in all three aspects of the game. So I know I can keep getting better. I know I can bowl a lot better than what I'm bowling even now. So I'm just working on my bowling. I'm working whenever I get to the next session, I make sure I improve a bit at least. And I always have a good chat with my bowling coach and try and get better each and every day, and look to get something from him which can help my bowling.
Yeah, Vijay, wanted to know that as the team strategy goes, like after 35th over or 40th over, it's Hardik who is going number 4, you are not going number 4. So does it create a pressure if you're coming in at the 46th or 47th over, like the kind of power hitting skills that Hardik has, you have to replicate that? Does it create another kind of pressure? Because probably you both are seam bowling all-rounders, so that creates pressure.
Definitely, no. The pressure will always be to deliver whatever the situation demands. So it is not about how powerful I am, because I've also played down the order. I've also got runs playing at number 6, 7. So it's not about taking that extra pressure. It is about taking extra responsibility and delivering it at the right time for the team.
Can you disclose anything about the 12 or last 12 or anything you want to announce about the squad tomorrow?
12 even? I don't know, sir. I'll know that only in the morning tomorrow.
Vijay, the way the England batsman dealt with Rashid Khan, he was supposed to be a great bowler. He's a great bowler, but he did suffer that day. So any plans to replicate an attack on Russia?
No, every day is different and every wicket is different. So, you know, you cannot take things for granted. So tomorrow might be a complete different scenario where we might have to target him or we might have to play off. So it is just about adapting ourselves to a different situation as quickly as we can.
Vijay, you've been with Rashid in the Sunrisers team. Really, as a player, as a bowler, you know, what are the, how do you look at his development, and you know, what is it that you have to watch out for when it comes to him?
He's definitely one of the best bowler right now in limited overs, and he has done well. So for me, being played with him for a couple of years, you know, it's very important for me to pick things from him. Like whenever I bat against him in the nets, I'll try and, you know, pick his variations. And definitely he's a good bowler. So anyone can go for runs any day. So it is about how we come back strong. So for me, it is about how I play against him tomorrow. So that will be the key.